Hey, what's going on? All-Star Basketball Coaches here. I am Coach Joseph. This is Coach Mark. This is Coach Lisa. This is All-Star Basketball's online instructional videos. We'll have them there archived on our website. Feel free to tune in and check out as many as you want. We're going to have a variety of different exercises right now. Coach Mark and Coach Lisa will be doing a lot of the demonstrations. I will be doing the narrating so you guys can get all the instructional cues verbally, and they will do a really good job of demonstrating it several times so you can really make sure that you learn these exercises. These are instructional videos for you. Practice them as you watch them. Do them in your living room. Do them outside, whether you have a court or not. Get your brother and your sister to join you. Get your mom and dad to join you. Very basketball related stuff. Today, we're going to be using the basketball a little bit limited, not a lot, but we got some really good basketball exercises for you. So we're going to get right to it. All right, here we go. We're going to challenge you today because we're not going to use the basketball so much, but that's okay. All right, Coach Mark, Coach Lisa, ready to show you some, first to start off, some defensive stuff. Obviously, we're going to put you first in the defensive stand, okay? One of the most basic things you need to learn in basketball, believe it or not, it's not shooting. It's knowing how to play defense, and you need to master this position. Your feet are open. Your arms are open. You can have one hand a little higher than the other. Sometimes people like to do that. Your back is a little bit straight, just slightly bent, and then you're ready to shuffle, okay? When you shuffle, you can shuffle up and down, and you can go side to side. So that's the first thing we're going to do. You want to shuffle like an L. You're going to go like an L. You come up, take a few shuffles back, shuffle to the side, just back and forth. You're doing basically like a little L. That way you're learning to shuffle to the right, shuffle to the left. You're learning to shuffle a little bit back, and shuffle a little bit up, up and back, and side to side, back and forth, very simple, right? Okay, now, at home, you're welcome to do that for a period. How do you do that? Put on a 30-second timer, do it for about a repetition of 20 times, put a timer, and then take a little pause, and then do it again. It can be short for like 10, 15 seconds, and then you can push yourself and do it for like 20 to 30 seconds, just kind of doing it without stopping, doing that little L form. Now, a more elaborate version of that, this is going to be two steps. We're going to first do it without a closeout, and then we're going to add what's called a closeout in just a little bit, okay? Instead of an L, you're going to do what's called a box, okay? Still in the defensive position. We're going to master this. You come up just like if you're coming. You're going to do a square. You move over because you're going to finish the shape of a square, and then you're finished right there. But then they continue because when you do it, you're going to do it, like I said, you're going to do it for about a 20-second period. If you want to push yourself for 30 straight seconds, it's a lot tougher than it seems when you get the time running and you're doing it without stopping, okay? The point is, your feet are not touching, your feet remain apart, and you do it as fast as you can. This is just a demonstration. Do this as fast as you can when you do it, okay? Now, Coach Mark, Coach Lisa, as they gather themselves, we're going to add the closeout. We're still going to do the square. We're going to come up. But now when you come up to that first point of the square, you're going to come out like if you're going to block a shot. Put your hands up in case you needed to deflect or divert a would-be shooter. You come up and put your hands up. And then you can put your hands down because now maybe the guy is dribbling to the side. You back up. And you learn to move all directions. First, do the closeout back. So all we did there, we're still doing the square. We add the closeout when you come up. Then you open up your hands and then back it up like that. And then back to the spot. Okay, again, do this for a period. It could be 10, 20, 30 seconds. You can push yourself. It's up to you. Do it for a short little timer. And then you also want to do it as fast as you can, but not so fast that your feet are not in the position and moving the way Coach Mark and Coach Lisa were showing you. Never touching their feet were, okay? All right. Now, here we go. We're going to move on to a vertical jump, okay? Now, when you're going to block a shot, okay, we're going to sometimes it makes you a better jumper. You jump just a little bit higher when you jump with one hand. Pick a piece of wall or something. A wall is probably the best thing, but it can also just be the air, okay? Basically, what you're doing is you're learning to jump. And notice Coach Mark and Coach Lisa, when they jump, they're basically reaching their hand as high as they can when they jump, but they're not bringing it down, okay? Coach Mark's going to demonstrate towards the camera what not to do if there was a shooter, okay? Here comes the shooter. The camera's the shooter. Coach Mark wants to block it. Ooh, he brought his hand down. If you bring your hand down, you'll have a tendency to do that. A lot of times what will happen is you'll either foul the person that's shooting or the referee will think that you fouled them because you did not learn how to jump up and keep your hands straight and jump straight up. You are a jumper. You jump a lot higher. You're much more likely to divert the shot and make it a tougher shot if you practice on working on jumping straight up and not bringing your hand down. Also, we're doing the one-handed jump because you will be a little bit higher of a jumper and probably a more effective shot blocker or a more effective diverter of the shot if you jump up with one hand. Okay, now let's practice doing a little jump with two hands. Sometimes you're going to be in a body position where you can't afford to jump with one hand just because you find yourself where you got to get up as fast as you can. You got to just jump with two hands up. Now, you may not jump as high. This jump is not as easy as the other one, but you still keep your hands up straight. Learn to do that. The point of this exercise is to be in the middle of action in a game, and when a shot is going up, you just jump up, okay? Let's add a little bit of a shuffle as Coach Lisa and Coach Mark catch their breath. They're going to come up. They're going to get themselves ready to come up, like if they're coming toward the camera, like doing that shuffle drill they were doing earlier. But when they get to the front, they're going to jump up, okay? Sometimes they're going to jump up with one hand, and sometimes they're going to jump up with two, okay? That is exactly what it will look like when you do this and you find yourself in a game situation. You shuffle up and do not bring your hands down. It is our nature to want to slap down because we see the ball, but it is likely that you will be called for a foul or you will actually foul the player that's shooting. So you want to come up, jump up with one hand, jump up with two hands if you can, either one. The only thing you're doing is you're trying to get some distance upward, towards the clouds, anything to make that shot more difficult, which is all you're really doing. All right, enough of the jumping. I'm sure you guys are fed up with the jumping. I know Coach Mark and Coach Lisa are. So let's get a basketball in our hands and let's do a few exercises with the ball. Now, a lot of our focus today will not be dribbling. We'll save that for another video, but we are going to do something with the basketball. You got to have the basketball so we can have a little bit of fun too. All right. So when you are in the middle of a game, sometimes if your teammate was really good at jumping up and making that shot difficult for the shooter, then that shooter is probably going to miss the shot. And that makes an opportunity for a rebound. So Coach Mark and Coach Lisa are going to show you a rebound exercise where Coach Mark holds it up straight over his head with his arm straight. And with his free hand, he's going to tip it up and then try to catch it. He's like, why are you tipping it up? Because you are simulating what is like a rebound. Sometimes Coach Lisa is on the other team, okay? Now, the ball bounces off the rim. Coach Lisa wants the rebound. Coach Mark may not be able to grab it, but what he can do is tip it. The ball's coming down. He tips it so he moves it just enough away from the other player so that he can then grab it. And once he grabs it, then he can open up his elbows and pivot away and look to pass it to somebody or maybe in some cases even dribble away. Now Coach Lisa will be demonstrating, tip it up. Now because she tips it with the other hand, she is giving herself just a little bit of space so the other player cannot grab the rebound and she can beat him. Now, sometimes it's a really close battle, but that's the idea. You don't need a partner to do this. You can do this completely on your own. Watch Coach Mark. He's going to kick Coach Lisa off the screen. Not literally. Okay. Then he's going to hold it up. He's going to tip it and grab it. And then from there, look what he does. He brings the ball down. He pulls his elbows out. And now he's ready. Okay. Then you can even add the pivot after that. From here, there's a bunch of defenders around you. All right, now Coach Lisa's going to come back in the screen. She's going to be a defender. When Coach Mark grabs it, she's going to try to steal it after he brings it down, but he's going to pull his elbows out and get ready to pivot away, protecting the ball. There you go. Let's do that one more time so you guys can see. She's going to try to steal it after she doesn't get the rebound, but he pivots away, and now Mark can be an effective passer to one of his teammates and start a fast break from there, or something positive can happen for his team. All right. Well, That'll do it for our exercises today. A lot of our defensive move focus and a little bit of stuff with the basketball, but more importantly, with rebounding. Coach Mark, Coach Lisa, and Coach Joseph checking out. Tune into our other videos. We got a lot of cool exercise and series of exercises on our videos here. We'll see you for the next one.